Saturn at Opposition. Welcome to Stargazers. I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plaw Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky tonight.
Dean and I are really excited because next week, one of our favorite planets will be at opposition. And as a result, it will be in a great spot in the sky and we can view it all night long.
And that planet is the ever popular and lovely ring planet Saturn.
Let's show you.
Okay, let's first explain a little bit about what opposition means. If we could view our solar system from high above the north pole of our sun, as we look down, we could see Earth's orbit and Saturn's orbit around the sun. Earth is about 93 million miles away from the sun, and it takes 365 and a quarter days for Earth to make one trip around the sun. In layman's terms, we refer to that as a year.
Saturn is the sixth planet from the sun, and is almost 900 million miles away. It moves much slower in its orbit, and it takes almost 30 Earth years to make one trip around the sun. Therefore, Earth makes 30 trips around the sun for every one trip of Saturn. So, it's quite obvious that Earth and Saturn are constantly changing their position in space with respect to one another.
When Saturn is at its greatest distance from Earth, it is on the other side of the sun as seen from Earth, and that is called superior conjunction, which happened 6 months ago on New Year's Day, January 1st. On that day, Saturn was a whopping 1 billion miles away from us. But 6 months later, on Tuesday, July 9th, Earth and Saturn will be lined up with the sun. Therefore, Saturn is on the same side of the sun as the Earth, and the Earth is a lot closer.
Or, if you think of it from our perspective, the Earth is in the middle, and Saturn will be on the opposite side of the sky with respect to the sun. This orientation of the sun, the Earth, and a planet is called opposition. And whenever a planet is at opposition, it is always at its closest and brightest. So this week, Saturn will be just over 839 million miles away. And although Saturn is always close to the Earth and very bright every opposition, this opposition is going to look great because of the way the rings are tilted toward us.
You see, even though Saturn's rings are always tilted at the same angle with respect to its orbit, because Earth constantly changes its position in relation to Saturn, its rings seem to tilt back and forth as seen from Earth during Saturn's 30-year orbit. For instance, back in January 2003, Saturn was in such a position that its rings were tilted up to the max, with the southern side of the rings wide open, which means that more sunlight reflected off the rings and made the planet much brighter than usual, and the rings looked their most dramatic.
Then, as year after year went by, we gradually saw less and less of the southern face of Saturn's rings. They slowly closed, so to speak, and by January 2009, we actually faced Saturn's rings edge on, and for a few nights, they seemed to have disappeared. However, as the years have passed, we are now positioned so that we can see the northern hemisphere and the northern side of Saturn's rings, making Saturn appear brighter in the sky. So, check out Saturn this week, and if you look at it through even the smallest telescope, trust me, you'll be blown away. To find Saturn, simply look east shortly after sunset. It will be in the constellation Sagittarius the Centaur Archer.
And while you're looking at Saturn, ponder this little bit of trivia. Of all the planets in the solar system, Saturn has the least density. This means that for as big as Saturn is, it's not as heavy as you might think. Its density is so low that you could actually float Saturn in a bathtub full of water, if you had a bathtub big enough.
Saturn in a bathtub. I wonder if...
No, don't say it, don't say it.
Well, the whole subject of Saturn in a bathtub does ring a bell.
Oh boy. On that note, happy Saturn watching and keep looking up.